Happy morning, children. I feel extremely glad to welcome you all for this online learning. We are doing a 10th standard science. Okay? And today it will be our biology class. Lesson 20. We have completed all the lessons. And now we are making a revision of our lesson 20, breeding and biotechnology. So it's in page number, you can find it in page number 286, page number 286, unit 20, breeding and biotechnology. So it's a very beautiful lesson. The explanation of this lesson's link is previously already given to you. So in our today's video, we'll be looking into the evaluation part about the question and answers. The 1 marks are there, which I will do during the revision time. And now let's start with our question answers. You got Roman letter 6 answer in a sentence. Then Roman letter 7, answer, short answers. Then Roman letter 8, long answer questions. So we'll be discussing these 3 criteria, that is in a sentence, short answers and long answers. I want all of you to take your book in your hand, have a pencil with you, mark the answers and try to read the textbook to get the answer. Okay? The first question, Roman letter 6, first question, answer in a sentence. Give the name of wheat variety having higher dietary fiber and protein. I've already written the answer, but let's go and search it in the book. Dietary fiber and protein, a wheat variety, okay. Where do we find it? Come to page number 288. Okay, it is Atlas 66, a protein rich wheat variety. So the answer for it is Atlas 66. So that is a 1 word answer. So you can take down Atlas 66. Second question, semi dwarf variety were introduced in rice. This was made possible by the presence of dwarfing gene in rice. Name this dwarfing gene. I've already written the answer, but let's go into a text and find out the answer. Okay, we are going to find out the name of the gene, dwarfing gene's name. Where do you find this answer? It is in page 287 on the top line, on the first line. Okay, and Digovogen, DGWG, a dwarf variety from China. Okay, so this is the answer for that question. Children, you should know why am I just turning to the textbook for referring the answer. This is how you should learn to get the answer for your questions. Don't refer guide. Don't copy from your friends. Every question that is given in the evaluation will surely have its answers in the textbook. So always search for the answers in the textbook itself. Okay? As you move to higher classes, learning from the textbook will help you to gain more and more marks. Third question, define genetic engineering. Define genetic engineering. For this, you can look into the glossary as well as into your lesson also. The glossary definition, the glossary is point to remember, you got the answer. Genetic engineering is the manipulation and transfer of gene from one organism to another organism. Okay, it is a transfer of gene from one organism to another organism. And you can also find the answer from inside of the lesson also. That is in page number 892, you got the answer. Genetic engineering is the manipulation of transfer of gene from one organism to another organism to create a new DNA called as recombinant DNA or rDNA. So in the points to remember, it stopped with this, to create another organisms. In the textbook, you can take an additional line also, to create a new DNA, which is called the recombinant DNA. So this will be the answer for your third question. Fourth question, name the types of stem cells. Name the types of stem cells. There are two types of stem cells which you can find in page number 294. There are two types of stem cells. Types of stem cells. Number one is embryonic stem cell. Embryonic stem cell. Number two is adult stem cell or somatic stem cell. So two types, these are the answers. One is embryonic stem cell, the other one is adult stem cell or somatic stem cell. So these are the two types. It's enough if you write only the name. They have not asked you to explain anything. Simply write the name alone. Embryonic stem cell and adult stem cells or somatic stem cell. Now let's move to the next question. What are transgenic organisms? What are transgenic organisms? You will find the answer for this in page number 295. In 295, on the first paragraph, you will find the answers. Where it is? This is the paragraph in that last third line. Plants are animals expressing a modified endogenous gene or a foreign gene are called as transgenic organisms. Okay, shall I repeat it again? Plants are animals expressing a modified endogenous gene or a foreign gene, also known as transgenic organism. So this is the answer for your transgenic organism. Okay, fine. Now let's move to the last question of Roman letter 6. State the importance of biofertilizers. Fertilizers are the substance which help the plants to grow more efficiently. They are like nutrient also. Mostly these are synthesized one made from chemical. But here it is given bio. Bio means living plants or animal content, which is used for the growth of the plant. So what is its importance? This particular question does not have the answer in the textbook. So let's take a general note of it. Okay. Biofertilizers add, the very first point, what do? They add nutrient through the natural process of nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixation is done in the roots, okay? Through the nitrogen fixation, nutrients are added to the plant. This is the first benefit. Another benefit, it stimulates the plant growth hormone. Plant growth is stimulated. Plant growth is promoted by the substance called growth promoting substances. So biofertilizers does two things. It does many things, but as it is a 2-mark question, we are confining with two answers. One is it adds nutrient through nitrogen fixation. Another is it stimulates the plant growth through plant promoting substances. Is that clear, children? So with this, we come to the end of our Roman letter 6. I want you to carefully watch this, mark the answer, learn the answer, and then write it in your classwork. Now let's move to the second division, that is Roman letter 7, short answer questions. You got around some 7 answers which we'll discuss one by one. Discuss the method of breeding for disease resistance. Breeding for disease resistance. In the very beginning of your lesson, in page 287, you got a topic called plant breeding for disease resistance, to make the plant free from the disease. What is the first point? Plant disease occurs by pathogens. Okay, pathogens means organisms which causes diseases. Okay, who are the pathogens here? Viruses, bacteria and fungi. These pathogens affect crop yield. Yield means the production. Okay, arvadai. விளைச்சல் விளைச்சலை அஃபெக்ட் பண்ணும் யாரு வைரஸ் பாக்டீரியா அண்ட் ஃபங்கை ஆஸ் ஹவு டு தே அஃபெக்ட் த ஈல்ட் பை காசிங் டிசீசஸ் ஓகே ஸோ பிளான்ட் டிசீஸ் ஆர் காஸ் பை பேத்தஜன்ஸ் லைக் வைரஸ் பாக்டீரியா அண்ட் ஃபங்கை அண்ட் தே அஃபெக்ட் க்ராப் ஈல்ட் ends அதனால ரொம்ப இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் டு டெவலப் டிசீஸ் ரெசிஸ்டன்ட் வெரைட்டி ஆஃப் க்ராப்ஸ் When you control it, you would increase the yield and reduce the use of fungicides and bacteriacides. சரியா? பூச்சிக்கொல்லி மருந்து, fungus வளராமல் இருக்கக்கூடிய அந்த fungicides, bacteriacides நம்ம reduce பண்ணிக்கலாம். அதிகமாக போட தேவையில்லை. ஏன்னா, செடியோட breedingலே நம்ம என்ன பண்ணிட்டோம்? இன்பில்டா. Disease resistance ku undu pannitom purida because this pathogens causes diseases we are manipulating the breeding system itself to show the disease for the resistance for this disease some of the resistance are given here neenga idu eppadi eluduvinga first you can take plant diseases causing pathogens like bacteria fungi virus okay affect crop yield so this will be your first point hence it is important to develop disease resistant variety of the crop okay this is second yield okay second point third point what you will take that would increase the yield fourth one and reduce the use of fungicide and bactericide so four points you will be writing then you draw this tabular column wheat The variety imagery, the disease, the resistance showed as leaf and stipe, rust till bunt. And cauliflower, cauliflower variety is Pusa, Subra and Pusa Snowball K1. The disease caused is black rot. Cowpea, variety is Pusa Komal and the disease is caused bacterial blight. So this will be your answer for the question. Next question is... Name three improved characteristics of wheat that helped India to achieve high yield productivity. Okay, we are going to name the three types of wheat which increase the productivity. It's also present in the same page 287. You will find semi-dwarf variety in wheat and rice. Okay, so the three wheat varieties are Sonalika, Kalyan is a separate name and Sona. Okay, three varieties. Who are the three varieties? Let me repeat. Sonalika, Kalyan and Sona are three wheat varieties from high yielding. Okay, they are used for the production. So, three wheat are Sonalika, Kalyan and Sona. Is it clear? Okay, now let's move to the next question. Question number 3. Name two maize hybrid rich in ammonia acid lysin. Okay, lysin irukka kudiya two maize variety we are going to learn. It's present in page number 288. You can find at the last line maize variety. Okay. Lysin rich maize variety. Who are they? Proteina, Shakti, Ratna. They have asked only two, but we have three. It's not bad even if you write three. Moon eludhuradhunala thappu kedaiyadhu. Who are the three? Proteina, Shakti, and Ratna. Is it clear? So this is the answer for that question. Now fourth question. What is fourth question? Distinguish between. You got two differences given here. Let's take A. Somatic gene therapy and germline gene therapy. Okay, somatic gene therapy and germline gene therapy. Very interesting and very important answers. Well, you will find this in page number 293. Page number 293, it's given over here under the topic gene therapy. somatic gene therapy, germline gene therapy. Just write the definitions, whatever is given. Somatic gene therapy is a replacement of defective genes in somatic cells. Germline gene therapy is a replacement of defective gene in germ cells. So this is a treatment in somatic cells, replacement of somatic cells, and this is a treatment, the defective, replacement of the defective genes in the germ cells, that is egg and sperm. That is the main difference, okay? The key term is replacement. We are going to replace. Replacing is called the gene therapy. Gene therapy refers to replacement, okay? So we are replacing the somatic cell, then it is somatic gene therapy. Replacing the germ cells, then it is called germline gene therapy. So this is your first differences, that is A, somatic gene. Next, B, undifferentiated cells and differentiated cells. You are going to differentiate two things. One is differentiated cells and the undifferentiated cells. You will find this answer in page 293, page number 293, and in the topic stem cells, you find differentiated cells, the other one is undifferentiated. Let's see what is a differentiated cell. Our body is composed of over 200 specialized stem cells that can carry out special functions. So this is a first point. Our body contains how many specialized cells? 200 specialized cells. And these specialized cells, what do? They carry out specific functions. That's it. Example, who are the specialized cells? Number one, neuron or nerve cells. Number two, heart cells, which contract for plumping. Number three, pancreatic cell to secrete insulin. See, neuron can do only that function. It cannot do any other function. For transmitting signal, avanga mattum dhaan seiya mudiyum. So, neuron is one. Heart cell, heart pump pandrathu heart cell ala mattum dhaan mudiyum. That is number two. Pancreatic cell is they secrete insulin. That is number three. So, our body is composed of over 200 specialized cells carrying out special functions. Example, neurons for transmit signal, heart cell for pumping blood, pancreatic cell for insulin. So this is called differentiated cell. Okay, differentiated cell, neuron, heart cell, pancreatic cell. Now coming to in contrast, undifferentiated cells are also known as unspecialized cells. Okay, the other name is unspecialized. What is it? The stem cells or the cells of variable potency. Potency refers to number of possible fates that a cell can acquire. The two important properties of stem cells, okay, they have the ability to divide and ability to give rise. But it is in a contrast, okay? In contrast to differentiated cells, are called undifferentiated or unspecialized mass of cells. And these cells, they will have the ability to divide and the ability to give rise to specialized cells. So this will be your answer for the undifferentiated and differentiated answers. Now coming to question number 5. State the application of DNA fingerprinting technique. DNA fingerprinting technique. You got this in page number 295. Page number 295. A separate heading is given as application for DNA fingerprinting. There are two applications. You can take the two applications. Okay. DNA fingerprinting technique is widely used in forensic applications like crime investigation and for identifying the culprit. Chariya culprit. Yaar kola senjaanga. Yaar thirudunaanga. So we can find that using the DNA fingerprint. Second, it is also used for paternity testing in any case of dispute. In okay, paternity. Yaar kithu urime. Inda urime yaar kora. Imunga kaiyachu. Aunga kaiyachu. Oray mari irukkaan paakarad. Okay. So in
solving the cases. Third one, it helps in the study of genetic diversity of population, evolution and specification. So for 3 marks you can write 3 applications. One is, it is used in forensic application for finding out the crime, identifying the culprit. Second is used for paternity testing in case of disputes. And third is, it helps in the study of genetic diversity of population, evolution and the specification. Now let's move to the next question. Question number 6. How are stem cells useful in regenerative process? How are they used in regenerative process? Let's turn your book to page number 294. Okay, 294. Stem cell therapy. Stem cell therapy means regenerating. Okay. Tissues and organs in the body may be permanently damaged or lost due to genetical conditions or disease or injury. Due to certain conditions, we may use our cells, tissues and organs. Okay. In case such a situation, stem cells are used for the treatment of diseases. அந்த நேரத்தில் நம்ம என்ன பண்ணலாம், ஸ்டெம் செல்ஸ் வச்சு நம்ம ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் பண்ணிக்கலாம், விச் இஸ் கால் ஸ்டெம் செல் தெரப்பி. இன் ட்ரீட்டிங் நியூரோ டீஜெனரேட்டிவ் டிசார்டர்ஸ், திஸ் இஸ் த ஆன்சர் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன். ஓகே, இன் ட்ரீட்டிங் என்ன டிசீஸ் பாருங்க, நியூரோ டீஜெனரேட்டிவ் டிசார்டர்ஸ் லைக், வாட் ஆர் த டிசார்டர்ஸ் யூ சி? Parkinson's disease and Alice Mayer disease. Okay, in treating Parkinson's disease and Alice Mayer disease, neurogenic stem cells can be used to replace the damaged or lost neurons. Okay, this will be the answer for your question number 6. Now let's move to 7th question. Very interesting question. Differentiate between outbreeding and inbreeding. Okay, this is regarding animal care, animal breeding, animal husbandry. It has got 2 types of breeding. In page number 291 you can find inbreeding and the other one is outbreeding. We are going to differentiate it. So before differentiating, let's look into the answer. Okay, inbreeding refers to the mating of, crossing of, breeding of, okay, having a reproductive sex of closely related animals with the same breed for about 4 to 6 generations. வித் த சேம் ப்ரீட், ஒரே வெரைட்டிக்குள்ளேயே கிராஸ் பண்ணிக்கிறதுக்கு பேர் இன்ப்ரீடிங். ஓகே, that is inbreeding. So let's come to outbreeding. What is outbreeding? It is a breeding of unrelated animals. Okay, this is a very simple definition, unrelated animals. சரியா, இப்போ எக்ஸாம்பிளுக்கு போய்டுவோம். எக்ஸாம்பிளுக்கு பாருங்க என்ன வருது, இசார்டேல் இஸ் அ நியூ பிரீட் ஆஃப் ஷீப் டெவலப்ட் இன் பஞ்சாப் பை கிராசிங் பெக்கார்னி Macra, Eves and Australian Merino Rams. Okay, Eves and Rams are crossed, two same, but they both belong to the same breed. Okay, one is from Punjab, the other one is from Australian. And this is crossed. This cross is between the same breed. In inbreed, we have good productions. Okay, but you see the outbreeding. Example, what is taken? Male donkey and a female horse. When you cross them, you get a mole. Okay, this is a picture given here. This is male donkey and a female horse. Both are crossed and you get a new species called mole. Okay, so this will be your second point. Third point, see, inbreeding, continuous inbreeding reduces fertility and productivity and sometimes harmful to the organisms. You will see what happens in the outbreeding. It is superior to ours in strength, intelligence, ability to work and resistance to disease, but they are sterile. We cannot make the mule cannot reproduce because they are sterile. So you put it in a tabular column, children. Take inbreeding on one side and outbreeding on another side. Write the first definition, inbreeding. and this single line for outbreeding. Then come with the example. Isserdale is a new breed of weave developed in Punjab crossing Bikaner and the Australian Merino ram. On that side, what you'll be writing? Crossing the male donkey with the female arch to produce a mule. You will write that. Then coming out the outcomes. Okay, reduced fertility and productivity and harmful for selection. Here they are good in strength, intelligence, ability to work, resistant to disease, but they are sterile. So this is how you will have to write this answer. Put, prepare a table or column of your own. Work it out, children. I can give a PDF answers for you to do it, but I'm not doing it because I want you to learn the answer. Okay, next. Moving on to Roman letter A, long answer questions. What are the effects of hybrid vigor in animals? Hybrid vigor in animals. You will find this a beautiful answer, a straight answer in page number 291. Effects of hybrid vigor in animals. Increased production of milk in cattle. Increased production of egg by poultry. High quality of meat is produced. Increased growth rate in domesticating animals. So this is the answer for that question. Next, question number 2. Describe mutation breeding with an example. You have to describe mutation breeding with example. Page number 290. Come to mutation breeding. First you take, what is mutation breeding? Sudden change. It is defined as the sudden change in the heritable change in the nucleotide sequence of the DNA in an organism. So that would be your definition for it. Okay, next. The organisms which undergo mutation are called mutant. Third point, the factors which induce mutations are called mutagens or mutagenic agents. First we are writing the definition, then we are talking about mutant, then we are talking about mutagens, and fourth is the types of mutagens, physical mutagens and chemical mutagens. Now we'll start with the physical mutations. Who are the mutagens? Radiations like X-rays, alpha rays, beta rays, gamma rays, UV rays, temperature. Okay, this will be your fifth point. Sixth point, chemical mutation. What are the chemical mutations? See, mustard gas, nitrous acid. So these are the chemical mutagens. And you got the achievements, the produced examples. They have asked, no, achievements of mutations are, write all these three. Sabarbadi sonari, wheat produced from sonari 65 by using gamma rays. Atamita 2 rice from saline with saline tolerance and pest resistance. Ground nets with thick shell. So this will be your answer. Let me repeat again. You will be writing the definition. Sudden change in the nucleotide sequence. Then what is a mutant? The organism which undergo mutation is called mutant. Then third point, the factors which is induce mutations are called mutagens or mutagenic agent. And the two types of mutagens are physical and chemical mutagen. In physical, it is X-rays, alpha ray, beta ray and gamma ray, UV ray, temperature, etc. In chemical mutagen, it is mustard gas and nitrous oxide and the achievements. So this will make your second answer. Coming to third answer, biofortification may help in removing id and anger. How? Eppadi biofortification is removing our anger. That is, how does it increase its production? You find this answer in page 288. Page number 288, biofortification. It is a science process of developing crop plants enriched with high level of desired nutrient like vitamin, proteins and minerals. So you will take the definition of biofortification and the examples you can take. Okay, Proteina Shakti Ratna, this full point. Then about Atlas 66 protein rich wheat, iron rich fortified rice and vitamin A enriched carrot, pumpkin and spinach. So that will make the third answer. Fourth question, with a neat label diagram, explain the techniques involved in gene cloning. Okay, this is again an interesting answer. Gene cloning, explain with the neat diagram. You will find this in page 292, gene cloning. Okay, so first you will write about cloning. In gene cloning, you will start with this. In gene cloning, A gene or a piece of DNA fragment is inserted into a bacterial cell where DNA will be multiplied as the cell divides. Okay, multiply and the cell divides. And you got an outline given here. 5 points are there. First is isolation of the desired DNA fragment by using restriction enzyme. Insertion of DNA fragment using suitable vector. Transfer of rDNA into bacterial host cell. Selection and multiplication of recombinant host cell to get the clone. Expression of cloned gene in the host cell. Okay, so 5 points, and then you'll have to draw this diagram. This diagram is very important. The last question, children, discuss the importance of biotechnology in the field of medicine. Okay, biotechnology in the field of medicine. You will find it in page number 293. The answers are, it is 5 point, insulin, treatment of diabetes. You can put it out in the tabular column, write the medicines and their uses. Make one column medicine, other column you make it as uses. So first we'll take insulin, treatment of diabetes, human growth hormone, children growth with growth deficiency, blood clotting factor to treat hemophilia. Next, tissue plasmogen activator to dissolve blood clot and prevent heart attack. Development of vaccine to treat diseases like hepatitis B and rabies. So you make it a tabular column and write it. This is the answer for your last question. Children, with this we have completed our evaluation for 20th lesson. Carefully watch it and mark the answers in your book. Learn the answers and then write it in your classwork notebook and submit. Thank you, children.